This thing I built looks like a little hologram, and the spaceship model displayed seems to float in mid-air, but in reality, this was made with a little trick that has been around for hundreds of years and still amazes me. When I was younger, I stumbled upon a video which claimed to show me how to make a hologram myself, but after doing what they did in the video, I noticed that what I made was not a real hologram, but just some sort of phone mirror trick. I was kind of disappointed because actual holograms do exist. They've been around for decades and are basically film that can capture and display a picture from multiple angles, but you need laser stuff to make them, and what discouraged me the most, they only display static 3D images. So if you want to make a holographic animation, you'd have to use a lot of them, just like with regular two-dimensional film. With a mirror trick I got tricked into though, you can display animations very easily, so I wanted to make a little something out of this illusion technique, which is called Pepper's Ghost Effect. First of all, why is it called Pepper's Ghost? A guy named John Henry Pepper made it popular in the 1860s by using it in his theater demonstrations. That's it. Nothing to do with the spirit putting too much pepper in your food. The concept is quite simple. Basically, you have some sort of display or well-lit area that is hidden and a surface that reflects whatever is shown there towards the audience. And because the reflecting surface is transparent, the audience also sees what is behind it. That's how you can make things seem to appear out of thin air. Or disappear again. John Pepper wasn't even the first one who came up with that trick. The first known description of the effect is found in a book from 1558 called Magia Naturalis, written by Giambattista della Porta. I want this thing to look like a little artifact that you can just put somewhere and let it look cool. So to keep it as compact as possible, I used a very small display with only 128 by 64 pixels resolution. This thing can only turn each pixel on or off, there is no in-between and no color. But because it is an OLED display, it's very suitable for these kinds of mirror effects, because the turned-off pixels don't emit any light to be reflected. Put that thing together with a microcontroller, a button and a few 3D printed parts, and that's it, at least regarding hardware. To actually show stuff on the display, I had to write Arduino code and use a library to display pictures in form of bitmaps, but to get those bitmaps I had to write another piece of code that converts JPEG pictures. So I went from video to very pixelated video, to single frames, to bitmap files, to display. A very streamlined workflow, I know. But I think it was worth it, because now I can make stuff like little retro game sprites appear in mid-air. Spooky! Or just show 3D models in all their low resolution glory. And even though this is just intended as a display for predefined content at this point, it technically does have Wi-Fi. So I might be able to use it as some sort of notification device in the future, or as a weird clock, I don't know. In the end, I just like this little device. The Pepper's Ghost effect is used in concerts and theme parks to really make you think there is a person that isn't actually there. But this doesn't have to have a practical everyday use. I made it, I learned something, and that's what makes this project worthwhile for me. And I can only recommend digging deeper into things that have been bugging you for years. What would you use this little machine for, and did you like this video? If you did, please let me know and consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.